Hey there, BHS! Welcome back to another episode of BHS-TV. I'm Anna Hauck.
And I'm Annie Tifo. We have an exciting episode for you today, Barrington.
Yes, we do. Let's cue that exciting intro before we start.
Hey Anna, how's e-learning going for you this year?
It's okay. I'm just thankful to be fortunate enough to have the tools and materials to make this odd school year feel normal. What about you?
You know, I feel the same way, but enough about me. Let's see how two students handled hybrid this year and e-learning.
I wake up at 6 o'clock out of habit. If I have an in-person day of hybrid learning, I go to get ready. If I have a virtual day of hybrid, as I do Monday through Wednesday, I work on homework, or practice dance, or work on an extra project till 7:30. For an in-person day of hybrid, I will be ready at 7 o'clock and go downstairs to eat breakfast and get ready to leave. I will make sure that I kept my hair out of my face so I'm not touching my face during school, and I will probably dress nicer. If I'm having a virtual day of school, as I do every day of the week now, or during hybrid, had Monday till Wednesday, I will go down to eat breakfast at 8 o'clock. At 7 or 8 o'clock, based on whether it's an in-person or virtual day of school, I will make myself breakfast before school starts. The last thing I would do before I leave for a in-person day of school is to pack my bag. I will pack my water bottle, my lunch, and my iPad. Everything else, I'll just leave in my backpack. Another difference between hybrid with COVID-19 versus normal school is that instead of taking the bus to school, I was driven to school. This year, my school day is different in many ways. First, that it's my first year in high school, so I know I have more homework. It is also different as we have gone about 1/4 of the school year without meeting our teachers in person. I'm also finding our freshman class of 2020 very fortunate as we get to experience the workload of high school, then we get to figure out how to walk our schedule and don't have to deal with that all at once. Many people will probably disagree as they feel like they're missing out, but I feel that it worked out in our favor. Dance and clubs are both over Zoom. For me, dance is probably the biggest difference, as we spend a lot more time dancing and don't really talk to each other as much, as well as the fact that we're not doing formations and stunts that we typically do in Bollywood dancing. I do dance one day a week in person, but we make sure we stay 6 feet apart and wear masks the entire time. Normally, I do my homework after dance, as dance starts right after school. Sometimes I have a lot of homework to do, and sometimes I don't have very much at home. Normally, I talk to my cousins, because talking to my friends doesn't work out. Either I or they will have a lot of work. After I finish my homework, or whatever I needed to do for that day, I will go to sleep. Normally, it will be about 12:30.
Hi, my name's Gabby Caranta, and today I'm going to show you what it's like to go to school during a pandemic. I decided to do hybrid because I learn a lot better when I'm in a classroom setting and when I'm surrounded by other students who are focused on their learning. School's a lot different this year than it has been in the past. Some obvious differences include having to wear masks and hallways being one way only. A less obvious change is that it's a lot more difficult to socialize with your classmates during class. A possible cause for this is that you have to be 6 feet apart from others at all times, and it just makes it a bit uncomfortable to have a conversation from that distance. Another really odd thing about school this year is that there can be a very small amount of people in your classes. During my AP Chem class, there are only 3 students, including myself, who are doing hybrid. It's really weird being in a classroom with 2 other students, but it's kind of nice because you're always able to get the help that you need from your teachers. While in distance learning, I felt like I wasn't hanging out with people very often. It was really difficult to make plans since I wasn't seeing people during the school day. I was also just so exhausted from looking at my computer all day that all I wanted to do was just relax once school ended. Although we weren't in hybrid for very long, I anticipate that I would have been hanging out with friends a lot more. So now I'll show you a little walkthrough of my schedule while I'm in person. First and second hour, I've AP Chem with Mrs. Foley. It's a really fun class, but it's a little awkward being in such a small class. It's really fun though. And third hour, I have math with Mrs. Moreras. This class is really fun since it's a bigger class, and I have some friends in the class. Fourth hour, I have PE leaders, which is also another really fun class, and I really like the teacher. Fifth hour, I have BHS-TV, which is obviously the best class. Sixth hour, I have French, which is another really fun class, and I love my teacher. And seventh hour, I have English, which is really fun because I have some friends in the class. Then eighth hour, I have open, so I'm able to leave. I personally can't wait for this pandemic to be over, and I'm sure that the rest of you share those same feelings. It's been really difficult not being able to go to school and not being able to see my friends, and I also really miss my sports. I never really realized how good I had it until it was all taken away. So I guess if there's any good to come out of this pandemic, it's a reminder to never take anything for granted.
Hopefully we can get back to school as soon as possible while also staying safe.
Indeed, but in the meantime, I'm glad we can watch some professional sports.
Yeah, that's true. But why don't we talk about our athletes with Riley Trapp, here to update us in the world of Barrington sports.
Hello, BHS, and welcome back to another edition of Barrington Sports Desk. Today on the show, we'll take a look at the new Wall of Fame inductees. I'm Riley Trapp, and you're watching Barrington Sports Desk. First up is girls golf. The Phillies will add the names of Sophia Dennison, Leia Guidos, Mara Janis, Simran Sine, and Sophia Sulkler to the Wall of Fame. The Phillies had a great season, which included an IHSA regional championship and an MSL West Division championship, and second place at sectionals. Congrats on a great year. Next up is boys golf. The Broncos will add Ian Bouchard, Dylan Dunn, Brock Dixon, Walter Grilly, Matthew Lee, and Owen Naughton to the Wall of Fame. The Broncos also had a great season that ended with a second place finish at sectionals. Girls Cross Country will add Gabby Andrews, Ann Berquist, Carly Drage, Molly Fitzpatrick, Ella Holterman, Catherine Shine, and Maddie Zebarth to the Wall of Fame. The Phillies had a great season, including an MSL West Division Championship. Next up is Broncos Cross Country. The boys will add a Grant Aggard, Alfredo Arnieri, Joey Furlong, Ryan Fryer, Matt Hargrave, Carter Hart, and Jake Zebarth to the Wall. The Broncos were conference champions and second place in sectionals. Next up is girls swimming and diving. The Phillies will add Emily Bucaro, Jenna Kerr, Lucy Ordway, Emma Pritchett, Lillian Reeder, and Alyssa Schwengel to the Wall. They were conference and sectional champions. Next up is the girls tennis team. The Phillies will add Almani Alvi, Priyanka Bogoraju, Abigail Carl, Sophia Hutchinson, Mishab Jamanachi, Chloe Kazaglias, Nurain Khan, Sam Kim, Olivia Pike, Priyan Shan, and Emily Yoon to the Wall. They were conference champs and got second place at sectionals. Congratulations on a great season to all the athletes. This about wraps up this edition of Barrington Sports Desk. As always, I'm Riley Trapp, sending it back to the studio.
Thanks, Riley. Hopefully all the athletes are making the best out of the events and staying as safe as possible.
Hey, Anna, we've already had 3 segments, but I feel like we're missing something.
And what could that be?
I just don't know.
Hey BHS, I'm Mia Lummi, and it's time to get you in the know. Orcasys Dance Company proudly presents their drive-in movie performance, Rise. It's on November 13th at 7 p.m. in the BHS parking lot. School Picture Day is going on this week from November 9th to the 13th. You should have gotten an email explaining what to do with a link where you can make a reservation by picking a date and a time. You can show up anywhere in between that 15-minute time slot you reserved and wait in the designated waiting room given to you in the confirmation email. Barrington Giving Day is having a donation drive. They are in need of new or gently used and clean coats, boots, snow pants, books, toys, and so much more. For more information or to make a donation, please visit BarringtonGivingDay.org. That's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. I hope everyone has a great week. I'm Mia Lummi, and now you're in the know.